Roti.
So roti is a wrap. Is it a wrap?
Roti is a wrap.
It's yeah. A wrap.
It's like a flatbread.
Okay, cool.
West Indian or South Indian? There's different places.
This is traditional Indian food.
So yeah, it's like everybody eats roti. They have different forms of roti.
Nice.
And I do these in here fresh every day.
Wow.
The way they taught us in India, it was called chapati.
Like my mom makes every day, she makes roti for the whole family.
Oh my God, you're lucky. This is what we needed on this island, is an Indian food place to eat.
They make them for their dog.
What?
Yeah, even for the dog.
Their dog eats fresh.
So when I'm reincarnated as a dog, hopefully, then I can be your guys' pet. And you can feed me some roti.
It looks like royalty. It sits on this velvet like chair, and there's
what
like,
a spoiled dog.
Around.
What's his name? Roti.
His name is Bruno.
Oh, Bruno. That's Italian.
Yeah, I saw your video, and like it was for sale, but I hadn't been inside, and
that's
I was googling
cool.
Like, you know, YouTube food garden and food carts, and your video came up.
Oh.
So before I met you or Andrea or even saw inside this,
yeah.
I saw your video.
Oh, that's cool.
And he was serving you beef and lamb.
And it was good. Like, it was really good.
So yeah.
He didn't have it that long though.
That's what
I don't think he did it too long. It's wild that he went back to Italy. Huh? Wonder
you know,
what he's doing there.
He did a lot of work to get this. Like, whoever put in the four sinks.
Oh, man, it's a lot.
It's not even on right now, but I'll be cooking on this next time.
Oh, wow, it's
this
a hot plate. Like,
that's a $1,000 piece right there.
That is sweet.
And the health inspector allowed me to use it as long as.
Oh, great.
Bar. Now that there's that bar.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, cool. Great. Oh, that's excellent.
So that'll be like the, yeah, in your video, he was cooking on that.
That's right,
and
he
I'm
was.
And I'm just doing curry, so everything's in crock pots and rice cookers.
Cool.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet.
So you're dipping it in flour.
Yeah, so this is how we do it. She taught me. And once you get them all, they're all kind of, you can use a scale.
Yeah.
About 1 ounce,
yeah.
And everyone's the exact same size. And then we get our rolling pin.
My mom got that rolling pin from India.
It works. Looks
it
like a,
works.
It's an exotic hardwood, it looks like. Looks like acacia wood.
That one's got a hole, but we can fix it. And I usually let them go a little bit like that, and then they stretch out really nicely.
It's like a pancake, kind of, right now, when you're rolling it.
Totally.
That's what looks like, a little pancake.
If you show, babe, can you show there? That's the finished product.
So that's the one that you made this morning.
Oh!
So that's how they
it's a wrap.
Yeah, that's
kind of like a flat wrap.
Yes.
Well, that's interesting.
And then we cook them up in the pan and we wrap the curry in that. So I'm going to make you one of those today on the
house.
Whoa,
that's awesome.
Like what gets the most action around here.
Well, what I had yesterday was good too. I had the curry butter chicken. Quesadilla thing,
yeah.
Whatever. Is it? What do they call that one?
It was a butter chicken quesadilla.
Yeah. That was good.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
That's awesome.
I love curry, eh?
I
love Indian food.
You like spice?
Yeah, no. Yeah, it's good.
I got some kick.
Not like burn my head off spice, but yesterday, yesterday was just right.
Nice.
Just like that ginger beer is just right.
Thank you.
It's not too sugary, and it's just the right amount of kick with the ginger in there, right? I find the ones you buy in the bottle in the store kind of like sugary.
They are.
Too sweet,
yeah,
like pop,
they
right?
They don't taste too much like ginger.
No, they don't.
They have a ginger artificial extract.
Yeah, no, they're fake. It's all fake. Manufactured, processed.
Yeah. Usually it cooks.
Okay, so you got your flat wrap there now.
So yeah, I usually do these in the morning.
Okay, yeah, this will be interesting to watch this cook.
I don't usually do these during lunch.
I think they cook pretty quick, eh?
They
yeah,
do.
And you can store them for like 1 week. They won't go bad.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Cool, good. That's great.
When I was coming from India, my mom made me like so many, so I don't have to like work on this.
Nice.
And then there's
so you have a supply of them.
There's different variations too, like they stuff them, they
create
like cauliflower.
Sometimes she makes, like,
oh, wow.
Cauliflower,
with curry.
Yeah.
Mm.
And it's just like it tastes good.
No, yummy.
She makes one style with, let's say, it has layer. You keep on peeling it.
Yeah.
It like takes off like 7 to 8 layers.
That's one of my favorite flavors is curry.
Yeah.
I just love it. Oh yeah. And you know when you go to India, I bet you a dollar goes a long way in India.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Right? It's like when people go to Mexico.
Same thing.
We're doing that in a few days.
I know you're really.
She's never been
to Mexico. See, a dollar goes a long way. When I go to Maui, a dollar doesn't go a long way.
Ooh,
yeah, I go every year. We go in the wintertime, and it's pretty expensive.
Yeah.
Yeah, Mexico, your dollar's gonna you'll be able to get a lot for less.
She's never been, so we're
never
excited.
Never been. We're like going in 2 weeks.
Cool. You'll have fun.
Yeah.
You'll have lots of fun. So you're heating that up.
Yes, we get the pan nice and hot.
Yeah.
And then when I get going, we usually have one cooking and then we roll the next one in it and keep going.
Okay, okay. And you put it in like oil. It's going to be oil.
Yeah, exactly. You put a little bit of oil in there. Sometimes the first one can be a little bit hard to get going. You need to get the right temperature.
Oh, is that right?
On oil.
Oh, okay.
So we'll see. Also the dough, if you overmix your dough or if there's too much water.
Oh, is that right?
There's lots of...
So the right consistency...
Yeah, it doesn't have to be very sticky. Like the dough.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it easy to burn it? Can you burn it?
No,
you
sometimes.
Yeah. It can happen.
Yeah, if they go on too long,
they'll burn hard
and they'll crack.
Sticky and they crack.
It's like a chip versus a soft roti.
There's a trick to making
these rotis. So what she'll do now at this point, she'll grate cauliflower and then put another one on top and roll that again. And then when you cook it, you get these layers with different spices and stuff coming through.
Oh, that's cool.
I'm not on that level yet, but next summer we will. I'm keeping them
You learned all the tricks of the trade from your mom.
Yes, exactly.
That's right. That's cool.
So I can tell that's a little sticky, so I'm going to just
dust it.
For
her, it's like so easy.
Oh, I know. And she's been doing it since she was a kid.
Yeah.
Right? Oh, look at this. Like flopping around pizza dough.
So this is how I get customers. I go...
Yeah, you flip it around like a pizza, but it's roti dough.
You tricked me with...
Roti dough.
So we had to come
like dosi dough, roti dough.
Dosi dough, roti dough. You make good videos.
Okay, so now we got that pan nice and hot.
So that goes in, we get right away to the next one, because time is money.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
People show up and are trying to roll.
This is your first food cart?
First food cart.
Cool.
I did culinary school 10 years ago.
Wow, in Victoria or Vancouver?
Vancouver.
Yeah, wow, cool. Like I say, my cousin is a chef.
Awesome.
Yeah, yeah, the one that was at Joe Fortes. Yeah, him and his father-in-law, Joe Fortes.
One of the best.
Yeah, and then his father-in-law, the cannery in Mulvaney's.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
Seafood is one of my favorites.
Yeah, he's Italian, right? We're Italian. This is good. I don't think there's ever been an Indian restaurant on Salisbury. This is like the first Indian food cart.
Nice.
Oh, look at that. Okay, so it's...
And then it starts to bubble up.
Oh, wow, look at this. Wow. That's really interesting.
Now you can add a little bit of oil. It's nice. I try to do minimal oil because it's not good for you, but the oil really helps.
Oh, yeah.
Hi.
How
was
that? So sorry about that ginger beer.
No. You make sure you watch us on my YouTube channel. I should give you my card.
You'll notice that roti's puffing up, fresh to order.
Hot. It's puffing and poofing.
It's puffing and poofing. Do I have a card here? There.
There we go.
That's
I'll give you.
Thank
it's going to be on Banana JSSI.
Nice.
Hey.
You check it out. Because a lot of other people are going to be checking this out. And they're going to want to come here and eat some of this stuff. Absolutely.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Take care. So much.
Have a good one. It's good food, isn't it?
Nice to see you again. Have a great day.
Happy customers. There's happy customers.
Good vibes over here.
See you later. See? Happy customers. Now you'll see yourself on there.
Nice. All right, so now we got our roti.
Okay, cool.
Fresh to go.
Wow.
And then we're going to pop that on the pan. And it gets fun.
This is where you load her up with stuff.
This has been in the crock pot for 8 hours.
Oh my God. So what's in that?
This is a hand-blended garam masala.
Oh my God. Oh, jeez.
Coconut milk, different spices. So now...
I wish I had smell-o-vision here, folks.
You're going to make an Indian...
But we don't have smell-o-vision, but I can tell you right now that smells good. And it's going to taste as good as it smells. Okay, look at that. Wow. I can tell you're a chef the way everything was organized in the place. You can tell this guy's a chef. It's not just slopped on the way. I throw stuff on a plate.
No,
it was like really nicely organized.
That's why yesterday I was so
out of trouble. No, it was good.
It was good, man.
It was like really nicely organized. Like when I watch these chef cooking shows, it's like, and they're grading you on how everything's put out. They say, okay, this is like a 10 out of 10 here. You don't expect that from a food cart?
Well, I was going to say, because it's a small space, you got to be tight.
It's really, it was pretty impressive. Everybody loved their food here. Look at that. See, there's the presentation.
It's a homemade cilantro chutney.
Oh, man.
This is just basic yogurt to help cut through
some. Oh, my God.
And then this is a homemade tamarind chutney.
Oh, I love tamarind. I eat that fruit.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's like a bean, and you take the fruits out of it. Yeah, I've grown some from seed, too. Look at that.
Street food, Indian style. Organic, healthy, vegan Salisbury.
This is nice. Look at, that's awesome. Just the way it's arranged there, it looks like a bloody artwork on it with a frame around it. This is beauty. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
That's pretty amazing. And we'll thank that God there too.
We'll We'll get back to work.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, thanks a lot. Look at that, folks. Come and eat here.
Enjoy.
This is beautiful. Yeah, right in Ganges at the food court. Cheers and aloha from Salt Spring Island.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Cheers.